let's get right into it. Let's start out with this morning's data. Productivity third quarter final was 1/10 less negative at -2/10, but it's still the first negative quarter since the end of 2015. Your thoughts?
Yeah, so the thing that's going on in the economy at the moment is that there's downward pressure on business investment. Trade war uncertainty is pushing down capital expenditures, and it's been really declining over the last 12 months. At the same time, hiring has been doing really well, as the employment report showed on Friday. So in that context, we simply have fewer computers, and we have more people. And in that context, it's not a surprise, really, that productivity is beginning to slow down.
Now, you mentioned what's going on with respect to jobs. You also have done research that shows quite clearly that non-residential business spending and fixed investment spending both have peaked right at the time the trade war began, and that's also having a negative impact on jobs. So what went right on this past jobs report?
Yes, so the somewhat puzzling thing is that employment growth is still so strong. What we've been looking at is slowdown, in particular in business investment. We've seen residential investment do better, so there's been some offsetting effect in overall investment picture. But with that backdrop, you would expect still that if businesses are investing a little bit less, if they're a little bit more cautious, if they're a little bit more worried about the outlook, that also should begin to have some negative consequences for hiring. And we've just not seen that yet. So it's pleasing that the labor market is still doing so well. But it does look like something has to give. We cannot have that CapEx is weak and that the employment report continues to be so strong.
Well, obviously, we see when we get optimistic news on either USMCA or trade with China, both interest rates and stocks move up a bit. But in the final analysis, what you're telling me seems to be that even if we get everything the market wants, central banks around the globe most likely are going to continue to push more liquidity in. Do you agree with that? Do you think it's needed?
I do think central banks need to continue to do something to help the global economic outlook. We still have significant uncertainty, not only about the trade war here and now, but also going into next year. We have also had that uncertainty associated with issues around the election. So we are a bit worried that that uncertainty might still hang over the market. But central banks are essentially trying to counter some of those negative things that are weighing things down. And if you look at the speed with which OECD central banks are cutting rates at the moment, this is happening at the fastest rate since the financial crisis. So there is a significant monetary policy stimulus in the pipeline that should be helping, and to your point, liquidity should also be supporting both markets and the economy. So that's why we do not expect a recession, but we're still watching those downside risks very carefully.
You know, real quickly, Torsten, another thing that you've demonstrated that I wasn't aware of, we are at a record divergence between consumer confidence and corporate confidence. Your final thoughts on why that divergence is occurring? Historically, it always seems to pick the beginning and end of business cycles.
Yeah, this is really noteworthy. I mean, relative to consumers are very optimistic compared to corporate CEO confidence. It's actually at the lowest level in 10 years. And this divergence is really unique. It's very unusual that you see that corporates are very pessimistic and consumers are very optimistic. And you're absolutely right, looking over the last 40 years, we've seen that when then divergence gets to the point where we are now, that normally means that we are at the end of the cycle. But given some of the CEO confidence is driven by trade war worries, we do believe that as those trade war worries will begin to fade as we go into next year, we should begin to see some convergence again. So we do not believe that this is the end of the cycle, but we're watching very carefully for this divergence and how it plays out over the coming months.